This is the all-new Solus 4.5 codenamed Resilience. The fan-favorite Linux distro has released a big update that's packed with improvements, new features, and a new surprise spin. Solus 4.5 brings a new and improved installation experience, big updates to the desktop environments, under-the-hood tweaks to improve the system performance, and a lot more. I've been playing with Solus 4.5 since it came out, and the overall experience that it's providing, this is more polished than ever before. Solus has always been a premium computing platform, and with this update, it just gets even better. So without further ado, let's jump right in and have a look at the 10 things new in the all-new Solus 4.5. Let's rumble. Solus smash it, the Budgie desktop jumps up to version 10.8.2. I wouldn't be wrong in saying that Budgie desktop is one of the biggest factors in Solus' success. Budgie desktop is modern, looks gorgeous, it's created using the latest technologies. At the same time, it uses a traditional layout that everybody is familiar with, and it's very easy to use. Budgie, while being fully functional, has that aura of minimalism. Budgie has always been fantastic, and with this new update, it gets even more amazing. This new update brings some important polishing touches. The dark theme option in Budgie desktop settings used to have effect only on the desktop elements like the menu and Raven, the sidebar here. But now, this setting is updated to switch the theme of applications as well, so this dark theme is universal now. Linux dark themes have evolved to be a kind of suggestive dark modes. That is, they don't forcefully make the applications dark, rather, they suggest that apps use a dark mode if the application has a dark mode. This doesn't break the look of applications that don't have a dark mode or don't want to use a dark mode. For example, the photo editor might choose to have a dark canvas no matter what mode the desktop is in. Solus 4.5 adopts this kind of dark mode here. Then, now when you change the bottom panel size, the icons there scale up and down as well. The absence of this feature makes changing the panel size a bad experience, as that would make the icons look odd. So great to see this feature added here. The notification system is also now improved. It also becomes more efficient with memory usage. The menu becomes vastly more intelligent now. You can just search for browser and all the installed browsers show up here. You can search for Excel and LibreOffice Calc shows up. Now you don't need to type in the exact name of the software here. The menu better understands what you want and gives you coherent results. This is brought about by implementing a mobile embedded artificial intelligence SLM that predicts what you're most likely looking for by analyzing statistical data in real time. Nah, I'm just kidding. There's no AI here. The menu uses keywords to give you results. When you type in browser, all the apps that have a keyword of browser attached to them show up here. Still, this is a pretty neat feature as it'll be very helpful for people who are new to Linux and don't necessarily know the name of all applications. We also get a brand new applet here. Budgie Trash lets you quickly view and restore deleted files and folders. And it also lets you empty the trash bin quickly here. This applet is going to find value where people often delete files and trash files. This is going to speed up those workflows. That's why this is not enabled by default, but it's there. You can enable and configure it from the panel section of Budgie Desktop settings. Apart from these, Budgie Desktop also gets polishing touches here and there and becomes an even more enjoyable desktop. Solus 4.5 brings a new spin to the family. Solus devs had announced earlier that they were planning to replace their Mate variant with XFCE. Somebody cue the drum roll and join me in welcoming Solus 4.5 XFCE version. The move to switch from Mate to XFCE is a strategic pivot to deliver an even more lightweight and even performant option to people who want to use Solus. People who want all the good things about Solus and a leaner computing experience. Yeah, Solus XFCE is definitely going to be faster and more responsive compared to the main Solus. But since this is their first release, the developers are tagging this version as a beta release. The beta tag is there just so you know that everything might not work in a fully polished manner. But I used it for some time and there were no issues or hassles here. XFCE desktop here has been stylized to look more appealing. The developers bring in a different theme and papyrus icons to add a modern touch to XFCE. The whole thing looks really good here. Excited for this. Solus GNOME Edition ships with GNOME 45.2. This version brings all the cumulative updates of GNOME 40 series right to you. There are many noteworthy updates from GNOME itself, but we'll focus more on what Solus has done here. Firstly, in this new version of Solus GNOME Edition, an extension called Speedinator is used by default. This extension increases the speed of GNOME animations and desktop effects, thus giving you a more responsive and snappier user experience. You'll feel your computer running quicker because of this extension. Then, instead of GNOME's default theme, Solus uses the Advaita GTK 3 dark theme here. This brings about a uniform look to all applications. Both GTK 3 Plus apps and the newer GTK 4 apps look uniform with this. There are many more smaller changes here, like when you open an application, they start centered on your screen. There are also many improvements from the GNOME side itself, like grid view in file chooser, which helps you identify images or videos better when uploading or choosing files. GNOME has been growing at a rapid pace. Every update brings improvements and new features. So it's good to see the latest version of GNOME in Solus. Solus 4.5 provides a great selection of gorgeous and functional desktop options, that's for sure. But the real power of Linux lies in the terminal or the command line interface. Having a good knowledge of Linux commands and being comfortable using the terminal really broadens what you can do with Linux and what kind of experience you are going to get here. So if you're interested in leveling up your Linux game, definitely check out my course Linux Mastery Express, which is the fastest way to learn Linux and start using Linux like a pro. I'll teach you a set of commands that will give you the confidence to use Linux without even a graphical user interface. Then we'll dive deep and learn how to use the V-Editor and master shell scripting with real-life examples. After teaching more than 100 students in person, I've curated this course with the top things that will level up your Linux skills the fastest. So if you're feeling like your Linux game is stuck in the same spot for too long and you're ready to take your Linux skills to the next level quickly, check out the link in the description below and get your Linux Mastery Express. We are running a massive 45% discount right now, so make use of it. Solus 4.5 brings a new installation experience with the Calamares installer. And let me tell you, this is a significant update to the Solus installation process. This move to switch from Solus OS installer to Calamares is an important decision and will be important for the future of Solus as well. Solus actually had a very simple and straightforward installation procedure. OS installer that was used before was very easy to handle, but it was written using Python 2, which has outdated long ago. Too long ago. So Solus switches to Calamares, which is a modern and feature-rich installer. This lets you easily use modern installation options like BTRFS and other advanced partitioning options. Also, Solus moves away from its dependency on Python 2. One stone, two birds. Also, Calamares is a popular Linux installer used by many different Linux distros, so more and more Linux users will get even more comfortable installing Solus now. Hold on to your headphones because there's a new media framework in town. Yeah, that didn't sound as cool as it did in my head. Following the trend of many Linux distros ditching the older Pulse Audio in favor of the newer and more performant Pipewire audio server, Solus 4.5.2 makes this jump. Pulse Audio is an audio server. It basically processes all the sounds coming out of your computer and it also manages various audio devices like your speakers, earphones, and other Bluetooth devices. It had been the go-to audio server on Linux for a couple of decades now. Pipewire is the newer media server that encompasses everything that Pulse Audio does it better and brings in more functionality as well. Pipewire is just faster and brings in reduced latency, which is noticeable. When you're doing some multiplayer gaming or using Bluetooth speakers or earphones, Pipewire provides noticeably low latency audio. It's also more secure and it works great with containers and it handles video as well. This change brings Solus up to date with the latest advancements in audio management and makes it all more seamless, and also brings in subtle performance improvements. Solus 4.5 brings in a boosted kernel. There's a lot here. Solus 4.5 ships with Linux 6.6.9. This is a very new kernel that brings support for a range of new and contemporary hardware. It also brings the latest performance improvements and features. This kernel has received many improvements, especially in networking and Wi-Fi departments. There are enhanced drivers here, there's Wi-Fi 7 tech, and a lot more here that will improve your networking performance. Computers with AMD hardware have received a lot of attention. AMD GPUs and processors get intelligent updates that increase the throughput. In fact, there's so much here that it could be a video on its own. AMD FreeSync gets updates that make the GPU more efficient. AMD power management gets even better, resulting in both better responsiveness and battery life. Linux 6.6 also brought in a new and improved scheduler called EEVDF. Solus 4.5 introduced a new and even better scheduler called the Bohr scheduler. This new version of Bohr scheduler is an improvement over the EEVDF scheduler. Solus 4.5 by default uses the new Bo scheduler. Schedulers have a big impact on the system performance and responsiveness, and this one makes the system deliver high performance while there is a strong emphasis on the responsiveness of the system as well. The system handles high stress situations very well with this scheduler. At the same time, for people who prefer to use more stable and well-tested kernels, the option to use Linux 5.15, which is a long-term support Linux kernel, is provided here. This is going to be a better option for many people who either run mission-critical applications or just need that extra stability. Linux 6.6.9 and Linux 5.15. You get to choose. Radeon Open Compute Platform, developed by AMD, allows your computers to leverage the power of the GPU to deliver an accelerated computing experience. Today, many people use AMD hardware. Solus 4.5 brings a major performance boost to these computers by enabling ROCm 5.5 support out of the box. What this does basically is, it allows for a boosted computing by offloading some tasks typically done by the CPU over to the GPU. It's hardware acceleration in applications. This vastly improves the performance and responsiveness by utilizing the CPU and GPU in tandem. Applications like Blender are going to benefit hugely from this inclusion. Even day-to-day things like browsing the web, watching videos online are going to get smoother. The crazy thing here is, Solus developers are enabling this tech on a large variety of AMD hardware by default. Even some AMD hardware that are not officially supported by AMD are getting this performance lift up. So if you have AMD hardware, expect a boost. Solus 4.5 brings a significant update to Mesa. Mesa is a big part of the graphics stack in Linux, and it's responsible for handling a huge amount of graphics workload. Solus 4.5 brings Mesa 23.3.2. Now, this version has many improvements and updates, which result in better performance as well as better quality graphics throughout. Various Gallium drivers get support here, which improve the graphics performance in many scenarios and applications. Gallium Zinc driver, Gallium VA API driver get added here. With these, video playback becomes better. OpenGL applications running on top of Vulkan get support. Intel's 7th and 8th gen GPUs get Vulkan support, and Intel's Xe GPUs get ray tracing support with these drivers. This version of Mesa also brings an experimental driver for VirtIO Vulkan. With this, when you are running virtual machines, the guest graphics driver will be directly able to communicate with the host's GPU. It's not GPU pass-through fully, but it's a similar concept. Considering how big of a headache getting GPU pass-through to work can be, I'll take it, and I hope it develops nicely. All in all, the Mesa update that Solus 4.5 brings is a big one and is going to impact your experience for the better. Solus KDE Plasma Edition brings KDE Plasma version 5.27. Plasma 5.27 is the last version of Plasma 5 series, and the next version of Plasma that we'll be seeing is Plasma 6. I've already covered what's new in KDE Plasma 6, so if you're interested in that, definitely check out my video of the 12 things new in KDE Plasma 6. Don't miss that. Solus developers have also done the groundwork necessary to prepare for Plasma 6, which is bound to release later this year. Solus 4.5 Plasma version brings polishing touches in the UI, a new screen tiling mechanism, and some cool other things. The tiling is pretty cool here. It's very different from what we are used to. You can press Windows plus T to open up the layouts and configure them however you want. Drag and adjust the borders, delete or create partitions here. Then, by holding down the Shift key, you can drag and drop applications into their partitions. This is tiling, but not all the applications are tiled by themselves. Only the ones that you explicitly choose are tiled. So this is kinda hybrid tiling. But the thing is, this is practical for a lot of people. People are going to actually use this and find it vastly helpful, so definitely try this one out. Finally, Solus 4.5 brings an updated set of software packages that ramp up your Solus experience to today. Solus 4.5 aims to provide a contemporary desktop experience by providing new versions of all the software. Firefox, the default web browser here, jumps up to version 120, promising a smoother web browsing experience. LibreOffice jumps up to version 7.6.4. So whether you're crunching numbers on LibreOffice Calc or drafting a document on LibreOffice Writer, you can expect work to be the same old and boring, but just on a newer version of LibreOffice. Actually, LibreOffice 7.6 has many improvements throughout. Also, this version of LibreOffice will be the last version to use this kind of version numbering. Beginning from the next version, LibreOffice release will have version numbers that are the same as the month and year of release. For example, LibreOffice 2024.02. Solus 4.5 also uses Rhythmbox as the music player of choice on the Budgie as well as GNOME versions. And Linux Mint Celluloid is used as the default video player on these two editions. Apart from these, there are many more updates to the packages that are in the repositories, so you can expect to install and use more contemporary versions of software packages. Solus has always been a Linux distro that has shown a lot of potential. It has garnered itself a close-knit and loyal community. Solus provides a very curated desktop experience. There's a touch of minimalism, but what Solus does, it does in a very polished way. Solus 4.5 brings this fantastic distro over to 2024 and prepares it for this year. I really enjoyed using this distro, and the new XFCE edition is going to strike a chord with the hyper-performance Linux crowd, but the Budgie edition remains my favorite. Definitely check out Solus 4.5. The download links are given in the description below. Alright, if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, definitely consider subscribing to the channel and leave me a big thumbs up. And if you're interested in leveling up your Linux skills, the link to my course, Linux Mastery Express, is given in the description below. It's designed to teach you Linux and take you from zero to hero within the shortest amount of time possible. You'll be using Linux like a pro within a matter of hours, so definitely check that out. Next up, check out the all-new Zorin OS 17. Zorin is yet another top dog in the Linux world that's doing some phenomenal work, and they've recently dropped a new major version. So absolutely don't miss that. Alright, this is Linux Techs signing out.